if f of x is equal to x square minus step of x square, 1 divided by 1 plus x square minus step x square. And given here, f of x is equal to x square minus step of x square divided by 1 plus x square minus step of x square. And since we know that x can be written as any real number, we can write step x plus fractional part of x, or we can write x minus step x is equal to fractional part of x, or also we can write x square minus step of x square is equal to fractional part of x square. And so we can write here f of x is equal to fractional part of x square divided by 1 plus fractional part of x square. Okay, and now here for convenient I will write f of x is equal to adding and subtracting 1 divided by 1 plus fractional part of x square. We can write this is 1 minus 1 upon fractional part of x square. So let us keep it aside. And since fractional part of x square is lies between 0 and 1 including 0, so which implies that adding 1 less than or equals to 1 plus fractional part of x square is less than 2. So which by taking the reciprocal, so we can consider here 1 upon 2 will be less than 1 upon 1 plus fractional part of x square is less than or equals to 1. And taking negative inequality will change here, minus half in greater than minus 1 by 1 plus fractional part of x square is greater than or equals to minus 1. And hence by adding 1 on both the 1 for the inequality, 1 minus half is greater than 1 minus 1 by 1 plus fractional part of x square is greater than 1 minus 1. So which implies that 1 minus half is half is greater than your 1 minus 1 by 1 plus x square is nothing but your f of x. F of x is greater than 0. So which implies that, so this can be equal to 0. So which implies that your f of x belongs to 0 comma half. 0 is closed and half is open. Therefore, we can say the range of f of x is closed 0 and half open. So we can go with option D option, right?